Hello and good morning, friends. Today I want to talk to you about what is the liquid level in a septic tank supposed to look like? Where is it supposed to be? How do you know if something's not working? So I want to talk to you about it. Let's go ahead and get into it. So we've talked about septic tanks a ton of times on this channel because that's kind of like what we do, right? But we all know that tanks are a big concrete box. Now, sometimes they're metal, sometimes they're plastic, sometimes they're cinder block, but they all kind of have the exact same liquid level parameters. And with that tank, it's gonna hold water. The purpose of the tank is to separate all of that solids from the liquid and get rid of it, right? The solid waste is actually gonna stay in the tank, but it's gotta get rid of the water. And that's where the absorption comes into play, and we've already talked about that in other videos. So with the tank, you're gonna have an inlet side and an outlet side. Traditionally in our area, you will only have two of those pipes. So you'll have one in, one out. If you have more than one coming in or more than one going out, usually that means somebody's not doing something they're supposed to do. We get a lot of homeowners who will make an addition and they'll come through the side of the tank with a new inlet line, or maybe they're concerned about backups and so they'll put some kind of overflow pipe into the woods or into the creek, and that's a problem. In our area, the moment you start kind of punching through the side of the tank, you potentially structurally compromise the system. The manufacturer is really the only one who's allowed to have a hole in the tank. The hole in the tank is going to be precast with, you know, the size for the pipe coming in and the pipe coming out of the tank. All of that's done by the manufacturer so that way the contractor doesn't have to do that. As a contractor, it's a really dumb idea to start cutting holes in tanks, because now you're taking the liability if that tank collapses or has any failure because of the way that you made the cut. Now, is it that common? No. Will most people run into problems? No. With a tank, the inlet pipe is almost always about 2 or 3 inches higher than the outlet pipe. The water level should be at the bottom of the invert of the pipe. So for example, you have your circular pipe. The bottom of that pipe is the invert. So the water level should always be at the invert of the outlet, so that way nothing really changes. On every septic tank, you're gonna have to have an outlet line of some variety, whether it's PVC, cast iron, terracotta, orangeburg, whatever type of pipe, you have to have somewhere for that water to get out of the tank. And so the water level should always be at the bottom of whatever that particular type of pipe is. But let's talk about how else can you tell if you can't see that pipe? In our area, generally tanks will have between 8 to 12 inches from the top of the tank to the top of that water level. And that'll usually put you right at the bottom of the invert of the outlet. Now, in our area, all of these tanks will always have a lid over the outlet line unless it's a homemade tank. Homemade tanks are problematic because they usually weren't really oversighted when people were installing them. So you never really know how strong they are, you never really know what the composition is gonna look like, and you never truly know how long it's gonna last. So that's why you can't have a made on site tank anymore. But it usually ends up being roughly about the same. So usually between 8 to 12 inches from the top of the water to the top of the tank. If the water level's any higher than that, there's a couple things that could be going on. The first thing that could be happening to you is you might have a backup because of a clog or a collapsed pipe or some kind of failure in the absorption system. That is going to be very problematic, but it's not going to be tank specific. Now, if you have something like this happening, the best way to figure this out is to dig up the lid on the back of the tank, run a camera through there, see what's going on. If you have observation ports on the drain fields or the distribution box, pop one of those open to take a look, see where the water level's at. Generally in our area, the cause for elevated liquid level, the most common cause I should say, is going to be a clog. And that's just because clogs happen all the time. It doesn't matter what kind of pipes you have, doesn't matter how good everything looks. If you put something down the toilet that shouldn't be going down there, it's going to get stuck in the pipes at some point in the occupancy of that home. That's going to be why all of modern systems are going to have so many extra pipes on the house and on the yard, so that way when inevitably you do something silly, or a guest does something silly, or somebody you know does something silly, you have a way of dealing with whatever that is. Another cause for higher liquid level than normal would be if the tank is leaking and you have groundwater getting into the system. Now, that's not super common with my area. I'm usually in the Western Maryland and like the mountains, but if you go to the Eastern Shore where the water table is a little bit higher, maybe you're in more seasonal floodplains, you could see that happening quite a bit. Leaking tanks are incredibly problematic. Now, a tank is supposed to be watertight, and how you check to see where the liquid level's at, right? So if you have groundwater getting into the tank, you will see water overflowing and spilling out through the outlet into the absorption system. If you have water leaving the tank, when you open up the lid, you'll see the water levels very low. So remember, 8 to 12 inches is what you want to see between the top of the tank and the top of the water. So if you open it up and the water is, let's just say, a foot and a half below that spot, now you know, that water's getting somewhere. There's only two ways that water leaves a tank, and that's going to be it's leaking or it was pumped. Septic tanks are watertight, and people will say, it can evaporate. No. You might see if it sits for 15 years that it could do that, but a lot of times what'll happen is it'll condense on the top of the tank and then it'll fall back into the water. So most tanks, you're not gonna see any kind of issues like that. I would say probably 99.9%. I've had tons of homes that have been vacant for 5+ years and the water level is exactly where it should be because the tank's not leaking. Leaking septic tanks are incredibly problematic in our state. It happens a lot because we used to use these things called mid-seam tanks. Mid-seam tanks were as it sounds, you would have half the tank, and then you would have a seal in the middle. The concrete's not usually the issue. It's gonna be the seal between those two halves. More modern tanks in our area are gonna be what's called a top seam system. So basically what they'll do is they'll put the seal above the water level. So that way, if for whatever reason that seal fails, rather than the liquid leaking out of the tank and into the surrounding soil, potentially contaminating wells and other water sources, it's all gonna stay inside the tank. You might have roots coming in, but as long as you're not planting trees next to your tank, you really shouldn't have to worry about that. As a homeowner, identifying a leaking tank is pretty difficult unless you know what you're looking for. So if you're concerned, if your tank's leaking, the easiest way to do this is just dig up the lid on the back of the tank, don't run water for about a day, and just see, is the water level still at the invert of the outlet? If it is, boom, problem's off, not leaking. If you don't have access to the rear of the tank, what you could also do is you could take a tape measure, measure from the top of the water to a location. Usually if I was gonna do that, it would be the top of the clean out. And you just take that measurement. Don't run water for about a day or two, and then take another measurement. Did it drop? If it dropped, well, there you go. Leaking tanks are hard to tell when the house is occupied and people are running water, because you could have a really, really small leak, but because you're running 200 gallons a day, 300 gallons a day through the system, you're basically topping off whatever was leaking out. On an occupied home, if the leak's bad enough, you'll notice the water level's low, but I would say those are pretty rare. I come across maybe one or two of those a month that are doing that on an occupied home. More commonly than not, it's gonna be a vacant home that you can find that the tank is leaking. Having your water level at the correct level for your septic system is incredibly important, because that means that the system's doing what it's supposed to do. If it's too high, that means something's not draining right. And if it's too low, that means the tank itself is not structurally sound and doing what it's supposed to do. So you can end up running into some problems with your well water, maybe cavitation around your yard, maybe sewage bubbling up. So it's important to make sure that whenever you're getting the tank pumped, somebody's looking at the untouched water level, letting you know, hey, when I opened the lid, was it above normal? Was it normal? Was it below normal? And then if they tell you anything that's not normal, you might want to try and investigate what's going on. I hope that you gained some value out of this. If you found this interesting, hit that like button, hit subscribe. I have more videos posted every day on the World of Well and Septic, and I look forward to talking to you guys tomorrow.